Sharp objects can kill you, especially if you're foolish in the kitchen. Hi, I'm SonicBlu Darkfold. This is my stabby thing, and we are making chocolate-covered strawberries today on Cooking with SonicBlu. Doesn't that sound like fun? Now, what we're going to do is we're going to start off by getting our double boiler out, and you know that how much I love working with double boilers. And we are going to melt these semi-sweet chocolate chips, courtesy of Kroger. And we are going give you some design tips on white chocolate to drizzle over it, and we're going to use this bottle that we've used in our previous episode of Cooking with SonicBlu when we made our peanut clusters. I'm going to use this again. This is a very handy thing to have, but if you don't want to save your French's mustard and out of fear of your chocolate tasting like mustard, then all you got to do is go to your local grocery store and get some of those plastic squeeze bottles that have never been used before. Those are perfect for it, but whatever you do, don't put them in the microwave because it'll melt all over. If you want to really remelt your white chocolate so you can use it again, right into boiling water and let it melt for a little bit and you'll have melted white chocolate, because this stuff does get hard over time. And I still have white chocolate in there and it's still good. So, we are just waiting for our double boiler to get hot enough, and while we are waiting, let us go and get our semi-sweet chocolate morsels. And open up the bag very carefully. You don't want your semi-sweet morsels to spill all over the floor. One bag. And look at this big, beautiful bowl of strawberries. Look at the size of these things. Aren't they gargantuan? Hands off my strawberries. Very serious when it comes to it. And of course you can also get nut topping to have as an extra little coating so that you can make them crunchy. So there are a million and one ways that you can design your strawberries, and I'm going to show you a few of them tonight. But basically, to get by the whole fuss and muss of having to make decorations, I can show you a few decorations that will probably be impressive, but nothing says it better than just straight drizzle on. So that's probably what we're going to do tonight. Now there is a method that you can also make them look very decorative if you have a very special occasion going. Like say a wedding or a graduation or something like somebody is going to be dressing up for very formally. And Rune actually suggested this one too. He knows how to do the tuxedo chocolate cut dipped strawberries. And in which you, instead of using regular chocolate, you use white chocolate, then you dip it with a V design in the darker chocolate, and then with white chocolate make the bow tie and the buttons. I won't show you how to do that. That's a little complicated for this, but I'll probably show you how to do one. Now, what you want to do is get yourself a spoon and stir your sweet morsels up. Make sure they're not the bitter baking chocolates. Make sure they are semi-sweet because people will be wanting to eat some of the stuff. And give it a good stirring. Now, to give it a good gloss, you remember my trick about adding shortening to your melted chocolate to make it glossy. Now remember, 1 tablespoon per 1 bag of semi-sweet morsels. And I just gotta find where my tablespoons are. Regular spoon. None of these are tablespoons. That's a tablespoon. So, let's get a tablespoon, 2 of them, to go into this very delicious, very scrumptious, hard to resist, very difficult to resist and smelling really terrific saucepan full of chocolate morsels, which will probably be eaten before we even finish this recipe the way I'm going on about them, but they are that good. I just can't stay away from chocolate. Chocolate!
Yeah. We know you can't stay away from chocolate.
I love chocolate. Okay.
Well, all of us do. What do you
think? We all love chocolate. Everybody loves chocolate. Even when you were a kid, you loved chocolate, and you love it even more as an adult. Why? Because adults see chocolate as an aphrodisiac. That means that if you prepare a lot of chocolates with your loved ones, you're going to get some that night. That is a very big word. Aphrodisiac. Can you say that? I thought you could. A lot of people are asking, Sonic, what is an aphrodisiac? An aphrodisiac is basically a lover's food. There are certain foods that are so delectable and so delicious, like chocolate, or even oysters, for one, can be an aphrodisiac. Oysters? Why would I want to eat oysters and then make love? I mean, wouldn't that make your breath stink? But apparently, it's an aphrodisiac. And an aphrodisiac just basically is a food that gets you into the mood. And chocolate is definitely the highest in aphrodisiac cooking.
Oh, yeah.
So, the next time you're in the kitchen and you cook with chocolate, just say to your loved one, I'm making us a surprise. She or he might just be in the mood to give you some that night. But anyway, enough about sex. Let's talk about food. Now we're getting... all of our melted chocolate is looking good. Nice and glossy, too.
Mm-hmm.
I bet that we could probably... I don't want to use a stabby tool. screw it. You lose a little bit of that, but hey, you know what? Nobody's perfect. All right, so, got your boiler full of melted chocolate, and it's nice and glossy, too. Look at that, how it reflects in the light, and look how it ribbons when it hits the saucepan here. Let me show you again. When it gets to that consistency, that is good melted chocolate. Nice and smooth and silky, that's what we want right there. There are no glops, no globs, no globules, no chunks.
No globules.
No globules. That's what they would say in the UK, no globules.
I was gonna say, did you make that up?
No, I didn't. That is an actual term used in Europe. They call them globules, where we call them globs. Okay. After you're done slinging chocolate everywhere from batting the spoon back, I have to taste test this chocolate, otherwise I might poison my guest. And we wouldn't want that, would we? Doesn't taste poisonous.
I don't think that they would sell that if it was poisonous.
Nope, that doesn't taste poisonous either.
Oh.
I thought I tasted something there, but no, it was just my imagination.
No, you're just wanting to lick the spoon.
No, I'm not. I want to make sure that this is safe to eat.
Right. You just want to have some chocolate.
That's pretty safe to eat, I think. Wait a minute, I'm going to need another taste because I can't tell.
Audience, would you say he's just wanting the chocolate off? Yeah. Oh, screen capture that one for...
Not poisonous.
Sometimes I don't know about you.
Sometimes I don't know about myself. Okay.
Okay.
Screen capture that, folks? Oh, yeah. I bet you will.
You know that. You know that.
Come on, Shadow Wolf. Come on, Dragonhead. It's kind of katana. You got to help me out on this. All right. What are we going to do now? We're going to get our stabby thing. And I'm using a turkey fork. But you can use a regular fork. You can use those little tiny forks would be preferred. You know those little tiny fondue forks?
Mm-hmm.
Use those. Those are really work wonders.
Oh,
but
yeah.
If you don't have that, anything that will pierce through the center of your strawberry. And all you got to do is just very carefully dip that sucker in the chocolate there. Try not to lose it in your chocolate. And it's best to hold it like that. Maybe... I need an extra tool. Oops, sorry.
Smack the camera, man. Okay.
Toothpick.
That might work a little better.
That might work a little better than the stabby thing, because I wanted to use this. I mean, I look dangerous with this thing here. I wanted to try it with a stabby thing, so... let me twist it around with the toothpick here.
Or you could always try something
dip it in like that.
You could always try something like this.
That could work too, but I think that would be just like the stabby thing. It just produces way too big of a hole. So, shake off the excess chocolate, and there you got one good dipped strawberry. It doesn't have to be fully submerged. And just lay that right down there, and just push it off with the toothpick, and there you have it. A strawberry is dipped. Now, let us try it with just a regular toothpick. Well, that one, of course, won't work because there's a huge hole in it. But this one might. What you want to do is you want to cut off the top of your strawberries, removing it of all of its stem. And it's just, yeah, the toothpick works great. There you go. Just dip it straight in, pull it straight out. And you can leave the tops of them uncovered if you want to, or you can dip the whole thing if you want to. There is no limit to the way you can dip your strawberries. But I suggest leaving the top part so that way you can push it off with your finger and not get chocolate everywhere. Now, how to go about dipping you? I'm going to go off to the side here and see if this will work. And just move it around like that, like that, like that. A little bit where... oh, I lost it. Okay, let's see if I can recover it.
This is very hot, so you gotta watch out for the heat. And it's very heavy too, so yeah, if it doesn't come up perfectly, then just lay that on that side. But as long as you got the most of that sucker covered. And that is a big, heavy strawberry to cover. But if you're acrobatic enough, you can do it. Okay, that one went right through, but let's see. Now I got some water in my chocolate. If that ever happens, just stir it right back in there and shouldn't be too much of a problem. As you can see, water on the strawberries just causes the chocolate just run off like that. So you definitely want to make sure your strawberries are dry. That's one thing I forgot to notice when I started doing this recipe. Definitely want dry strawberries, that way the chocolate won't run right off. But if that happens, just keep on dipping it until it does coat, and eventually it will coat. There we go, see? Easy solution to that problem. And there you go. Just repeat the process over and over again, or you can design them however you want to. And you can design them, you can cover these as much chocolate as you want. And you can design them however you want to, be creative, but have fun with it. We're gonna do the rest of these strawberries first, and then we're gonna come back and we're gonna show you the white chocolate drizzle. And that'll be coming up in a few moments. But first, let me mix this water up in the chocolate real good. So that when we come back from choking with SonicBlu, we should have chocolate-covered strawberries ready for drizzling. Boy, if you thought chocolate was an aphrodisiac, wait till you try it on strawberry.
Yeah, just don't do a sexual like on the air. That just doesn't...
I'm telling you, this is a very heavenly flavor. Well, as you can see, we've covered most of our strawberries over there. We still got plenty to spare over
there. Yeah, there's still plenty right there.
But I wanted to do just enough to accommodate 2 bags of semi-sweet chocolate morsels. You're still going to be left with a lot of chocolate. Now, the water mixed with the chocolate thickens it up like that, and you can't use it. But I found that if you find that your chocolate is starting to thicken up, take the spoon that you're using to stir the chocolate, and you got to stir it constantly, and keep the boiler on a very steady heat. And just take your strawberry into the spoon, and then do like this, round and around and around and around, so that it's on the spoon, not in the saucepan, and you come away with a beautifully coated strawberry.
Well, that's one way to do it.
Yes, it is. Now look at that. Now it might not look glamorous, but it'll taste out of this world.
Yeah, it doesn't have to be glamorous to taste good.
Exactly. And that's what definitely is practiced here, making chocolate-covered strawberries. Now we're going to try to flatten that part out there and try to stick it down here onto the wax-coated thing there. Okay, there we go. Now as you see, some of them are coated with chopped nuts, and that's a combination of peanuts, walnuts, and little almonds here and there. And you can get those already pre-made in the stores, or you can chop them up yourself. But and all in all, I think we've got us a good start on chocolate-covered strawberries, as you can see. Now, what we're going to do is we're not going to put them in the freezer, we're going to put them in the refrigerator and let them chill. Give it about an hour to an hour and a half of chilling time. And I hope that that closes. It closed. Now, we're going to chill that for about an hour to an hour and a half. And then we're going to add our white chocolate. Now, if you got some chocolate left over and you don't have any more space on your cookie sheets, could always take the leftover strawberries and just take a collection of the chocolate in here and watch out, because it's going to be very hot. Take a nice big strawberry like that and just dip it. And this is a very messy task as well, so if you don't think this is messy, plan on making a huge mess. That way you won't be too surprised when you realize what you have to clean. But it is irresistible. Look at that, I'm doing it with my finger. There we go. Oh, almost.
Almost there, not quite.
Okay, come on there. Cover. Well, as you see, the thicker the chocolate, the harder it is to coat, and especially since you got wet strawberry going into very thick chocolate, and this will thicken up, so there's not much you can do about that, because you also fail to realize that the strawberries are very juicy when you puncture the tops of them with a toothpick, or with a fork, if you choose to use a fork. But I think that this, despite the thickness of the chocolate, will make for a very excellent tasty treat. And it's one that your family and friends will love, and they'll love you for it, for making it. Now I just gotta wait for this guy to cool down, wait for the rest of them to chill, and then when I pull them out, we're gonna drizzle them over with white chocolate. And that's gonna be the easiest task, especially since we got that squirt bottle over there. So what do you say we come back in about an hour and a half, and we'll start lacing these up with some really good white chocolate. And like I said, you can make different decorations as well, but as you see, I really don't have the facility to do the big time fancy schmancy decorations. I can only just show you exactly in the ways of describing it, how to do it. Like those tuxedo ones I told you about. If you got a special occasion like a wedding or something, the perfect thing to do is take your strawberry and dip it in full on white chocolate, and then take the strawberry with a fork, of course, and you dip it in a V shape like that, so that you get your dark chocolate, or your milk chocolate here and here, leaving a V of white chocolate exposed. And then you take your darker chocolate, you make a little black necktie, or bow tie. And that's easy to do, just, you know, make a little bow tie shape. And then with the white chocolate, make little dots for buttons. And you got yourself a tuxedo. But I think that looks aren't everything in the ways of making a really sweet treat. It's the taste that counts. Man, I'm telling you, I feel like I've just grown wings and I'm floating up to heaven. That's how delicious this taste is. So we're going to wait for about an hour and a half, come back later, and we'll do some white chocolate drizzle on the next coming up with Cooking with SonicBlu. And I'm going to have me another one of these. Lovely.
Well, as luck would have it, I wasn't able to do the drizzle on the chocolate-covered strawberries. Well, what ended up happening was, I ended up having some Salisbury steak that night. And let's just say the Salisbury steak didn't quite agree with my system. So unfortunately, I wasn't really feeling in the mood to stand in the kitchen an hour and a half later, after the mixture of Salisbury steak and chocolate-covered strawberries kind of mingled together in my stomach. And let me just tell you, folks, chocolate-covered strawberries was meant to have as a dessert for a reason. Don't ever snack on chocolate-covered strawberries before eating Salisbury steak. Now, I don't know if that was the effect of it, but when I did have that Salisbury steak, I was pretty much sick in bed for the next day. And by the time I was finally able to get back to my strawberries to do the drizzle, the strawberries, let's just say, weren't all in the best of moods either. We had to toss them. Yeah, what a blow. All of those beautiful chocolate-covered strawberries with nut topping, totally ruined. Here's a little tip for you all. In making your chocolate-covered strawberries, also be very quick about eating them as much as you are in making them. It's very vital for your plan on making some really good chocolate-covered strawberries. Just a little healthy tip from your old buddy SonicBlu Darkfold. Oh, and if you can avoid it, I would not advise you eating the Salisbury steak. So, I will end on a positive note that what I did have of the chocolate-covered strawberries was awesome. So, try them at home, you'll love them, and they're easy to make. That's all I have to say. So, hope you enjoy yourselves, and watch out for that Salisbury steak. It'll kill you. Bye for now.
Send an email to sonicblu@yahoo.com. Thanks for watching, and remember, if you're not cooking good, you're not eating good. for now.